David Iglesias was one of the federal prosecutors fired by the Bush administration in 2006 for what White House officials say was due to performance-related issues. Horizonte's Nadine Arroyo Rodriguez talks to David Iglesias about his events leading to his removal in office in his latest book, Injustice: Inside the Scandal That Rocked the Bush Administration.
I wanted the American people to understand why this is such a big deal. Because a lot of times you'll hear on talk radio, oh, you know, there are a bunch of political appointees, you serve at the pleasure, any reason, all that's just not true. I mean, most reasons are completely okay to let go a political appointee. But when you start weaving all the really disturbing threads, what happened to Paul Charlton here in Arizona, Carol Lamb, McKay, Cummings, myself, it looks very much like interfering with ongoing investigations. It looks like retaliation for investigating or convicting Republican members of Congress. And that's not what the Justice Department has ever done. I mean, it's just wrong. And I wanted to speak out. I'm a son of a minister. Right and wrong is something that really means a lot to me. So I really wanted to lay out in very simple terms why this was so wrong and why the American people need to care about their criminal justice system.
Did you ever question yourself as a person, as the professional that you were at that moment?
No, but I remember thinking, if I speak out, I mean, the only really hard question initially is, do I speak out about this? Or do I just go away quietly, like my former colleague Johnny Sutton advised me to do? Because I knew if I spoke out, I'd be taking on the most powerful Republican in my home state, Pete Domenici. I'd be taking on Heather Wilson, who was pretty popular. I knew that despite my desires to run for office after my U.S. attorney job, that like Cortez, I had to burn the ships at the beach. I knew there was no going back, and that's why it was so difficult. I knew it would be a life-altering event for me.
Did you ever feel fear? Did you feel?
Absolutely. I mean, not personal fear in the sense of they're going to hire some thugs to beat me up, but a kind of a cold, paralyzing fear of I'm going to have a hard time getting a job, I'm going to get blacklisted, I'll be treated as persona non grata. And to a certain extent, some of that did occur. But the response from the rank and file citizen in New Mexico and throughout the country has been tremendous.
When I read that book, you got emotional?
I've never been as angry in my entire life. And I'm a pretty, you know, tranquilo person. I'm pretty calm. But when, especially when I found out they forced out superstars like Charlton and McKay and Lamb, what are they thinking? I mean, they didn't pick low-producing, low-morale offices. They picked on people who did the right thing. But that wasn't good enough because they wanted the politically expedient thing. And that's not what U.S. attorneys do of any administration, liberal or conservative.
You had Karl Rove directly involved in one of your friends' removal that you talk about in that book, and
yep,
his battle between what to do and what not to do.
Right. And I feel terribly for Bud because they at least told the truth about Bud Cummings in Arkansas being removed because they wanted to give one of Rove's lieutenants a job. And the guy's only qualification was opposition research against Al Gore. Never been a prosecutor. Well, I think he'd done a few cases in the Army Reserve. But in terms of having a real caseload, dealing with victims, going to crime scenes, he hadn't done that. He didn't understand the incredible, not just the power, but the responsibility you have as a U.S. attorney.
I'm glad you said it. You get angry because even your wife questioned you when you came home and said, she questioned you. You said, she questioned me. I couldn't believe it, but then I could understand it. Mm-hmm. That she would say, did you do anything that you were not supposed to have done?
I think any spouse would have asked that question. You get fired and you think it's because you did something wrong. I mean, that's the natural response. But in this case, and not just for me, but for all of us, we did the right thing, and that was the basis of our removal.
Do you feel your integrity? Do you feel your persona was directly attacked?
Not initially, but later on they were trying to say I was disgruntled, I should have known, you know, I've got zero rights as a political appointee, I should have just gone away quietly. And that just completely fails to understand the bigger picture, which is you can't politicize our decisions. We have to be independent.
Where do you go from here?
Well, the Justice Department, I think, has made some progress in terms of reducing the amount of communication between the White House and the Justice Department. Karl Rove is gone, which is very important, because he never understood. He just I write about him thinking of this as summer help with law degrees. And I still think that. So I think there's less of that going on now. But I think there won't be a complete redemption until there's a completely new administration.
Do you think there's a purpose to what you went through?
I feel it's really important for you to find what your purpose in life is. And I think my purpose was to help clean out the festering mess that was there at the Justice Department, unexposed, hidden. And because of my colleagues and me, we were given an opportunity to help clean that mess up. The process has begun, and it'll be complete sometime in the next few years.
Does this make you feel vindicated, or you're not there yet?
Oh, I'm very close to vindication. But you know what? When the Inspector General's report comes out, that's the internal review. If it contains what I think it's going to contain, I'm still going to write to whoever's the Attorney General. I'm going to ask for a retraction. Because they have not retracted what they said about my colleagues and me.
You're going to fight that.
I want a letter on Justice Department letterhead saying you were terminated for other than performance reasons.
You're going to the private sector, because that's something you never really tapped into when you talk about that.
Yeah, no, I've been in the private sector now for about 8 months or so, and it's nice to earn a nice paycheck.
You like it better?
Yeah, better. It's different. It's not concerning justice. It's concerning the bottom line, so it's a different focus. But it's nice not to have to watch my back. That's a good feeling.
Iglesias is wrapping up his nationwide book tour in September.